Hello everyone, let's talk today about the second part of the topic on national team management and the under 21 process. Today, so we will talk about the perfect age for an under 21 prospect. We will talk about the experience that a player can gain thanks to the matches in the national team, and we'll try to understand how a staff can select a cluster, a basket of player that will face and will play in the best competition like the Continental Cup and the World Cup. So, in the previous video we talked about Nigeria and its pool of 100 youth teams. We spoke about the under 17 staff that with the community is working to select and train the best prospect from 15, 17 years old. All this process is more or less long 7 months, that are 2 or 3 seasons. After this process, you will have more or less 200 or 500 players, depending on the quality of the work done by the staff and the quality of the academies. Consider that in Nigeria you can have average users that promote by generation 2 or 5 players that are really good or interesting for the national team. So after this process, we have this basket of player. The under 21 staff will follow them from 17 years old until 21, 22. The skill and the potential are important, but not only. Also the age is important, because for under 21, the age means that if is not perfect aligned, some player can miss some important matches that can support the team to arrive in the final of the competition. So this timeline is really helpful to you to understand how is divided the competition, the process of a generation. Speaking about always about a competition, so in the first phase we have the Continental Cup, that for Nigeria is the African Cup, and we have a second phase that is the World Cup. The African Cup is composed by 4 groups in which we have 6 teams, and the best 3 teams will be qualified directly to the World Cup after 10 matches. The first 2 teams will go in the final phase to win the cup. So, considering this element, we need to try to understand which are the perfect age. Of course, we need to find, as staff of under 21, the player that can play until the final. Sometimes, also for the pool of player, you cannot find a good player with good age or perfectly aligned with the final. Maybe you need to have a range that at the end a player that can play until the match 10 is still good, and also sometimes you need to check player younger but with good potential that can be able to play at least until the final to complete the team. On top of that, is important to know that you can leverage on players nasty fellow. Why? Because the team spirit is important, like for the club, to boost the of course the rating of the midfield. You need to know that in a national team you can have 26 players. You can add every player you want without any risk to reduce the team spirit. But if you remove one player, the risk is increasing by depending by the character. The nasty fellow is the player with the low risk to drop the team spirit. So sometimes useful to select some player nasty fellow that have good skill that can boost the rating. Maybe they can play just for the 5, 6, 7 match, but they boost and support the team in that match, and can be useful. About that, these are more or less all the information that we need to know to scout and select in an under 21 staff 30 core players that can play in the African Cup, because we know that 26 player can be can play only. So we need to have 30 player that can be selected, considering that can have the risk to have a core player that can have during the competition a bad form. On top of that, we need to check also the workup. So in the workup, we need to do the same work. We need to find 30 players, core players that can play until the final to face all the competition, and some, depending on the pool, depending on the players that you can select, sometimes you cannot face and you cannot be competitive against important team like the European one, so you need to add some player that maybe have age that is good just for the round one or the round two, but just to complete the team and to be competitive. But the main team still need to be with a good age for the final, because the boost of experience that you have in this round will support you, but at the end of the competition also you need to be careful with the team spirit, because more you go round the next round, more the reset of the team spirit will be reduced and you have a risk to be less competitive versus the opponents. Here we can see an overview of the experience. The African Cup is really important for a player, because gain 200 X point, that means 2 levels of experience. So versus a normal player that play just in the club is a huge difference, but the most relevant tournament for a national team, of course, is the World Cup, and you can see here how much experience your player can gain. I give you also here a detail with the table about the experience for each game. So a quick example: in the World Cup we can gain for one match 28 X point. You can have a look about all the other competition, and just the difference between a league match in the club that give you just 3.5 X point is really huge difference. So the national team competition, you can understand how much is important for the growth for the player, both for the national team but also for the owner club. In the right of the slide you can see the impact of the experience in terms of the contribution of the skill of the player. For each skill, a solid experienced player will have a boost of 1.13. So this is really important to know. At the end, with this chart, we would like to show you the difference, the huge difference of experience that a player can have thanks to the World Cup or the Continental Cup versus a player that can play just in the club. You have an impact on the skill, and just at 22 years old, your player can really have a huge boost in terms of experience and ratings. Finally, we are at the end of the video and we can see the generation timeline in which the player from the academies and from 15 years old, step by step, will reach the 29 years old and the national team. All this process means 5 years. It's really a long period in which we have in each phase a risk to lose player from a better training in the youth academy. Maybe the player won't be promoted after the promotion. The player could be trained by a bad owner that is not fitting the training, the target of the under 21, or maybe have a bad staff or a stamina too high, and he is reducing the potential of the player. Also, after under 21, sometimes there is a risk to see the player sold after the competition, and completely the new owner completely change the target and the training, and the potential the player will be completely stopped. At the end of this, we need to underline the work done by each staff, because in the Yacht Academies, the under 17 staff, the main target is to boost the promotion of the good players and increase the cluster of players that the under 21 staff will follow. The under 21 staff need to find the perfect owner and buyers to protect the generation, and after 1 year and a half, evaluate the 80 core players that will be boosted by the competition with the experience. After that, the national staff will follow these 80 core players, but not only, also the player that maybe have not a good age for under 21, but still have a good potential, need to follow all these players, trying to preserve a little bit the target, the final target to reach the 29 years old. At the end, after 2 years and a half, finally we will reach the target, and the player can play in the national team, and we'll see really ratings amazing and the best value that you can see in Hat-Trick. So that's it. This is the life cycle of a player, and I hope that you can understand the huge work behind the national team for each phase, for each staff. And also, when you have maybe a prospect, you can study a long project with your own club, trying to put some prospect for the national team that will be training in a good way. So sometimes, if you have you speak with the national team staff, try to support them, because you need to understand the work behind. And so maybe sometimes you buy a player that is followed by 2 years, and sometimes if the national team try to save him, because maybe your target are not fitting with this player, but it's really important save him. So really think about when you build your own team, about your project, and try to support the national team, because at the end for me it's a win-win situation in which the player and the owner is training a player that will be boosted by the experience of the national team, and the national team need to be careful and need to be to support also the owner, because the owner is training in the best way with a good stamina share, with a good staff, and with good target. And if the trainer is following the national targets, really both the side need to support each other. That's it. I hope that the video was helpful for all of you, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye bye.